Right, thank you very much to Big C there for making the video, and the new intros are sick, brother. Okay, next over to West Ham United. This season hasn't been the greatest for West Ham. They have managed only 20 points. Even so, they stuck with the team and battled on to try to win some more. Their defence and attack hasn't been too hot this week, and have picked up 0 points. Unlucky West Ham from a possible 15. The top goal scorer for them is IIX Neymar XII. He has picked up a massive 15 goals in only 17 appearances, which is great. Better luck next season, West Ham, and over to Eclipse.
That's it for West Ham. Okay, over to the final team in BPR, which is Tottenham Hotspur.
You got dick twice this week.
This week has been a good. This has been a good season for Spurs. They haven't played their best, but they still have done well enough to top the BPR.
Yeah, still fluke the BPR. Yeah.
They have picked up a massive 44 points, which is unbelievable. The top goal scorer, elusive, with a massive 17 goals.
17 games, you're shit, mate. You're going back to Barsman, bruv. Were you chatting?
Spurs could go on now to win the league, but it's not in the bag yet. So let's put the shitty clip on and see what happens.
We'll be right back.
have it. Okay. Is it me? You.
It's me. Okay.
You.
Key players.
Okay, now over to the key players for the BPL. First for the BPL is Bradley MC, 1996, the centre-back for Newcastle, has only played 4 games this season, but has had a cracking week with 3 clean sheets. In the 4 games, his team has been solid. With 5 tackles, 15 interceptions, 16 clearances, and a game-saving block, he has been one to watch. So keep your eyes out there, boys and girls, for obviously Bradley MC 1996. Okay, moving on to the second key player, which Dan's going to talk about.
Right, second key player is Captain Pop Farmer. The Man City player has got 7 clean sheets in 14 games, along with 7 assists and a massive 49 interceptions. The key player status suits him, as a Man City wouldn't be half a team without him in midfield. Right, Championship.
Okay, Championship. First, we have Derby. This week, Derby have been amazing, picking up 8 out of 12 points. Derby have unfortunately missed out on the Championship title. But all is good, as they have guaranteed themselves second place, which seems them being promoted to the Premier League next season. Obviously, bear in mind, there's still 2 games left. So someone who write this has gone a bit hasty. Right, okay. One of the main reasons for this is their striker, A3 Josh. Seeing him score an amazing 16 goals in 21 games, with the season coming to an end, we wish Derby good luck for the next season and hopefully gain promotion. Over to Derby Clips.
On the ball in midfield, well read by the player in that part of the pitch.
That was Derby. Right, I'm going to leave the mic there. It seems better. Ipswich then. This week, Ipswich have been reasonably good, picking up 6 out of 12 points. Ipswich have definitely had a week to be proud of. This sees Ipswich moving up to 10th place, only 5 points away from the top 5. One of the main reasons for this is their striker, Ark Alex, seeing him score an amazing 13 goals in 13 games. With only 2 games left, could we see Ipswich break into the top 5? I'm just going to check. We got no Ipswich clip.
Okay, no Ipswich clip, unfortunately.
So, sorry about that. So, we'll just move on.
Get the other one, Leicester one.
Leicester.
So, we got that ready, yeah?
Right, I'll try.
Okay, then. Right, bear with us 2 seconds, lads. Right, okay. Finally, moving on. The last team of the Championship this week is Leicester. Right, this week Leicester have not been very impressive. Obviously, Jamie Vardy is not on fire. Picking up only 3 out of 12 points, Leicester have definitely not had their best week. This sees Leicester drop into 6th place. On the bright side, the main man, Sons the I-72, has been proven a tough opponent to get past, making 5 clean sheets in 12 games. But it's not over yet, as Leicester still have 2 games left to try and boost their team up a few places before the end of the season. Okay, we're going to now, if you bear with us a couple of minutes maybe. I'll tell you what, we'll talk about the key players And then hopefully the Leicester clips will be downloaded so we can come back and show you the Leicester clips, all right? So moving over to the key players in the Championship then.
Right. First we have A3 Chris. The Derby centre-half has had a storming season so far, and this week he has kept up the pace. With tons of clearances, tackles, interceptions and 6 clean sheets, he has most certainly been a standout player in the Derby side. Can he push on to make team of the season after the last few games, or will his form slump? You never know. Over to Yardi.
Okay, so the other key player for the Championship is his teammate and manager, TSN Wright. His season so far has been insane. 16 goals in the 21 he has played, as well as getting 16 tackles and a huge 20 key passes. The Derby manager is still fighting for that second spot. Can he help his team to get it? Only time will tell. Unfortunately, the Leicester clips are still downloading, so what we're going to do, we're going to jump over and we're going to show you the English Goal of the Week instead. Okay, there's the English Goal of the Week for you. Unfortunately, we're still waiting for Leicester's clips, and at the moment we've got Ipswich clips as well. So what we'll do, we'll carry on with the show, guys, and then we'll have to come back to Ipswich and Leicester towards the end of the show. So over to Dambo to talk about the BBVA and the first team Real shit.
Real Madrid, okay. Real Madrid are having an awesome season and are battling to win the title, as they're only 1 point ahead of second place Barcelona. Ouch.
Bottle.
Real Madrid have only lost one game this season, which puts them on 51 points. You have to give credit to their defence, though, as they have only conceded 15 goals. ASDX Danny has had 53 tackles and 77 interceptions, along with McCohen I-13-1-I-don't-know.
Yeah.
Who's had 29... McCohen. Who's had 29 tackles, 55 interceptions. Real Madrid are also very good at passing, as CFIP has had an amazing 315 passes.
Can I just point out, he's on the leaderboard for his passes, yeah? But he's also on the leaderboard for failed passes.
Oh, he's on the leaderboard for failed passes,
I'm just
too.
I just point that out. Sorry, Pete.
And Jace with 245, so keep it up, Real Madrid. the title might just... You can pray, can't you? But the title might be yours, but I can't see it happening. I reckon you'll bottle it at the end. Right, here we go. It's Real Madrid.
Okay, well done there, Real Madrid. Moving on next, we have Osasuna. Osasuna has had a pretty good season as they're currently sat in third place in the league with 45 points. Let me just clarify, that statement there is not good enough. Yeah, Osasuna, right, have definitely were the underdogs coming into this league. Everyone was speaking about Real Madrid, Barcelona, it's going to be all between them two. But let me tell you, that is actually not true. Osasuna, yeah, I've definitely give both of our teams a run for our money. So, big respect to your team there. I'll carry on and read the rest. Okay, 14 wins, 3 draws and 3 losses is a great record. They have got an amazing keeper. Number one Munich fan, he has had 9 clean sheets and 101 saves. The unthinkable, which I think is old legend, Pedro Marsalf in the World Cup, is also having an amazing season with 19 goals in 19 games and 11 assists. Keep it up for the final 2 games, Osasuna, and obviously over to Eclipse and best of luck.
What he was trying to do, but the pass wasn't on. It was a bad ball, as it turned out. We'll be right back.
Right. Osasuna done. Moving on to Barcelona. Barcelona are having an extremely good season as they are fighting for the first place. Barcelona are on 50 points with Real Madrid just 1 point above them. They have got two quality strikers, Yardi 2000 and shit, and he has 17 goals and 9 assists with his partner Barsman, who has got 24 goals and 9 assists. Their brick at the back is Clearance Kev, as he's got 63 clearances, 11 blocks and 34 interceptions. Good luck on winning the league, Barcelona. Let Yard say some shit if he's got anything
to
say.
Yeah, I got loads to say.
Go on,
then. Hey, who written this fucking shit? What about bigger than the rest of my fucking team? Yeah? Hey, boys, it takes a team, yeah? And that's what we are. Barca's a team. Yeah? And we're true spirits, man. We're going to fight for this shit. Yeah? So all we got to say is, Real Madrid, I hope you're on your game tomorrow, boys. Yeah? And you don't bottle this shit. Because if you're going to bottle it, we're going to pinch it from you. And that's enough said. Yeah? Over to our clips. Bust this shit, Dad. Okay, right there you have it. Some of the Barca moments there. Moving over now to the key players for the BBVA 1. The first key player this week in La Liga is the Osasuna centre-back legend Campbell. Whilst not getting goals from corners, he has most certainly been awarded at the back for the title challengers. Getting a giant 8 clean sheets in 10 games that he has played, along with 30 clearances, he is definitely a defender to beware of, and maybe a contender for a personal award. Only time will tell. Moving over to Dambo.
The other key player is a well-known player across the website. Everybody knows him. It's Potted Pete. Pete's got himself 10 goals and 16 assists in his Real Madrid side this season. But that isn't even half of the story. 31 tackles, 40 interceptions, 315 passes won, 412 passes lost, and 46. Yes, 46 key passes. Is there anything that Pete cannot do? Pass the ball properly.
Yes.
Only time will tell.
What Pete can't do is get his team a title because he's going to bottle it.
We're all going to bottle it. Yeah. Clem knows. Right. Over.
She knows.
Do you want me to read your bit while you do that?
Yeah, carry on.
Right, over to BBVA 2. First, we have Sevilla. Sevilla have had a great season. They are currently sitting fourth place and have 39 points from 20 games. They don't have any draws this season. The Spanish side have lost their last two games. Unfortunately, they can't win the title, but promotion is still mathematically possible. Good luck, boys. Here we go. It's a Sevilla clip when I find it. There we go.
Pumped up kicks, best to run fast when I pump up this. Musical block and the shots go firing. No lying, man, I run this shit. Life a movie, man, I run my script. Similar to hustlers that run they strip. I shouldn't say similar, cause similar is equal. I ain't similar to niggas, they ain't nothing like this. I found a bottle with a note in there. It said the world broke and go repair it. But it seems that no one cares. So I threw the bottle in the ocean, yeah. I never chose my gift, my gift chose me. I don't owe y'all shit. Just guarding a gun and I loaded up clip. And a voice full of soul and it goes like this. Life is just so scandalous, but still I paint with honesty. That's why they love us on my canvas. I'm like Pete Sampras, my service is so enchanting. I took a song by Foster the People and fostered it into Jonas's anthem. Nigga, I'm a beast, panther, and I don't know no answers. Thought I lost my soul 15 years ago when I lost my father to cancer, but I'm still here, shit, and I refuse to quit. Just got in a gun and I loaded up clip and a voice full of soul and it goes like this.
Okay, there we go. Right, France are apparently spanking Iceland 4-0 at the minute, so at least we didn't get through. Next, we have Celta Vigo. Celta Vigo were top of the table for the majority of the season with key players like Calajon, Shabubu, and Reese. But they've recently had a poor run of form and have dropped to third place in the table.
Shabubu hasn't been on form. He's had a code.
He asked the medic for time off,
but he got refused.
Yeah, the medic wouldn't give him time off because he's, I don't know.
He's a superstar. He's just got to get
must be their superstar. Uh-huh. Right, they can't win the league, but they could have promotion. So good luck in these last few games. Over to the Celta Vigo clip if we got one.
Here
we are.
Okay, wow, there you have it. Now we're going over to finally. Is that right? You haven't done that?
Yeah.
Have we?
Idea.
Ouchie. Ouchie. Are 4 points behind the league leaders. Okay, so they're 4 points behind the leaders. Right, okay. With only these few games remaining, they may be able to clinch the title. If they count on Malaga dropping some points, but they have been slightly inconsistent in the past games. They need to be at their best to have a chance at the title. So come on, Ouchie. I want to see you step it up, boys. We're going to show you some Ouchie clips now. Okay, now we are going over to the key players, I believe. Okay, key players this week for the BBVA 2. Firstly is Levante's main man, Oi Luki. With 30 tackles and 35 interceptions, he has been a key player in the event. Oh my Jesus Christ, Levante team. Banging in 8 goals and getting a fair amount of assists, he has been a team player for his side and has been a big help in getting them to where they are now. Okay, the final BBVA2 player, key player this week is Mozzie UK. With an award worth 72 interceptions and 47 tackles, he has been a rock at the heart of the midfield for his Malaga side. Whilst looking for the league title, they have definitely had their chances upped with Mozzie. And good luck to you all in the future. Okay, before we go over to the Bundesliga, I think we're going to show... Yeah, before we go, should we play the goal of the week first? And then what we'll do then, we'll bust on the Ipswich and the Leicester clips for you. So we'll go over to the goal of the week first then. All right, and Dan, sort the goal of the week out first then. We'll start with that and then we can go from there. Okay then, here you go then, boys. Hope you okay, boys and girls, today we're going to do it a little bit different. I am going to give you a running commentary of these goals as it happens. This is it, the starting from 5. Here we go. Okay. Bam, boom, boom! Oh my fucking God, it was like a butter. Get the fucking lad. What a fucking header. Oh my days. Did see that come in. Okay, moving on to number 4 then. Oh, it's a free kick. We have a free kick. Some of it. Oh my God, he only hit the crossbar and went in. You damn it, cunt. I don't fucking believe it. Oh my God. Let's go on to 3. This bloke's a joker. Who we got? Oh, it's me, main man, Barzy. Boom! Oh, keeper done smoking! Oh, Barzy, mate, you must have learned that from the yardie himself. Great goal there. Okay, moving on to number 2. Who we got? Oh, that's a ping, that is. That's a ping. Oh my God, that must have been 55 yards, if not more. What a goal, lad. Oh my God. You spampy and it went in. Oh my God, you're going to have to teach me that. Okay then, now moving on to number one. Oh, let's have a look. Oh, it's only me, myself. Boom! Oh, and he buried it. Fuck off, all of you. FGL, you're the number one. Tell your friends. Woo! There you have it. Tune in next time. Bitches! Myself laughing. I'll pass you up to Dan. I can't even talk no more.
There we go. That was what was different this time. So, what do you want? Is that how you want them, or do you want them to be a bit pissing different? We can. There's either commentary over them, or we'll just put music on it. It's up to you. How do you want it? But if anybody. If anybody don't like the swearing, you just have to say or deal with it, to be honest.
Well, I can't change it.
He can't stop swearing. He swears too much. So,
yeah,
right, we are going to stick on Leicester, if I can find it. Leicester. How was it spelt? There's Ipswich. No, we'll do Leicester first. They want it like that every time.
Oh, okay. Right, I can do that. Yeah, I can do that.
That can be done. How's Leicester spelled? L-E-I-C-S. Because somebody spelled it wrong. So we go here.
Yeah, I can do that every week, I think.
Right. Where is he? Here. L-E-I-C-S. There he is. Right. Here's a Leicester clip. There was Leicester. Right, over to the Ipswich clip now quickly, and then we'll be back on track with what we've got to do. So here we are, here's Ipswich.
Oh, mistake by the goalkeeper. Shots on here. Into the challenge, he made the block. Wonderful. This could cost him. Can he do it? And it's a goal here.
That's a
Right, there we go, last Ipswich. On to the final league, which is the the Bundesliga. Right, first we got Borussia Dortmund.
Oh no, I can read that bit.
Dortmund. Have not had the best season, as they have had a lot of manager changes. And currently 10th in the league. Dortmund have 21 points with a positive goal difference. They currently have no manager, so if anyone wants it, carry on.
Dortmund needs a manager. So
Borussia Dortmund needs a manager.
Big team as well. Borussia Dortmund.
Yeah. Right, I need to find that clip.
Have we got Dortmund clips? I'm guessing we probably got no Borussia Dortmund clips.
Is it me? Let me have a look.
I can't see we have, to be fair.
No.
Well, clearly we've got no clips for them because they've got no manager.
Yeah,
so.
No clips for Dortmund, so no clips. Right, next in the Bundesliga we have Borussia Mönchengladbach are not doing the best in the league, as they're currently 11th. They have 5 wins, 1 draw, 14 losses. Key players got beat Ryan 3. He's got 4 goals, 7 assists, 51 tackles and 46 interceptions. Some amazing stats right there. Good luck for the rest of the season, Mönchengladbach. And now I've got to try and find your clip if we've even got one. I don't even think we've got one for them, have we? Gladbach.
Gladbach.
Here we go then. Here's that clip. Right, over to Yardi.
Okay, last but not least, we're going to talk about Bayern Munich. Bayern Munich are doing pretty good in the league, as they are currently sat in 7th position. Their last 5 games have been pretty good under their new manager, Rico 86 and DJ Nix on 23. As they have had 3 wins, 1 drawn, 1 loss. Good luck getting in the top half of the table, Munich. Now over to the Bayern Munich clips. We will just get them for you, boys and girls, so just bear with us. Okay, here we go. We'll be right back. thank God that bloody damn shitty song is finished. Anyone that uses that song next week, I'm going to ban you physically myself. That song is fucking a mindfuck. Please don't use it. I've had to burst my eardrums 3 times after that shit song. Right, okay. On to key players for the last time tonight. The first key player we have for the Bundesliga is Joshua Gunning, 95. The Wolfsburg centre-back has been the conductor of the team, orchestrating the defence and letting people know their roles, getting a massive 11 clean sheets and once again being in contender for Team of the Week. Along with his 57 clearances, he will be in contention with Kevster for topping that leaderboard. Congratulations, Joshua! Okay, moving over to Dambo.
Final key player for this week's match of the day is the Hamburger Machine, Stuttgart 1090, getting a huge 86 interceptions along with lots of tackles and clearances. He will definitely be a contender for next week's Team of the Season. Oh yeah, end of the season next week.
Yeah, awards night.
Awards night and everything. All that stuff coming up. If it's not the All-Star team. No, if not the All-Star team.
Yeah.
He'll be either in the Team of the Season or in the All-Star team. Is there anything that Stuttgart can't do in defence? Definitely a player. Shit. Definitely a player for the strikers to be aware of if they want to keep their ankles intact. Right, over to you, Hardy.
Goal of the week.
Goal of the week.
Okay, well, he's passed it back to me, but we're going to go over, obviously, to the German goal of the week. And no, I didn't commentate on this one, but I know as you found the commentary quite funny, obviously, you know, that's something I would do as next week onwards. So here we go. Okay, well, there you have it. Okay, so now we're going to move on, obviously, to the much anticipated Team of the Weeks. First Team of the Week this week we're going to start with is going to be the German Team of the Week. Okay, well, here we go. Starting from the... I downloaded that one for you. That's the one I didn't. Right, bear us a set, boys.
Right, there we go.
Okay. Right, so, right, starting from the top then. First we have, starting from the top, should I say starting from the bottom, goalkeeper. This week is Higgsy20X. He has been outstanding in goal. He has definitely saved his team from losing games. He now has got 107 saves in just 22 appearances, which is amazing. He has definitely earned a Team of the Week spot. Okay, next we're moving on to left back, which, oh my days, it's only Connor. Connor 25X, well done there, lad, plays for Wolfsburg, by the way. Who has also had an amazing season in defence. His defensive skills have definitely helped his side from losing games. He now has got 44 clearances in only 22 appearances. Well-deserved Team of the Week award. Okay, next centre-back, he's already been mentioned, is Joshua Gunning, 95. He has been amazing in the centre of the defence. He now has 57 clearances in only 20 appearances. I think we've said that before, but hey, he has definitely deserved to be in Team of the Week. Moving over now to Dambo.
Right, in centre-back, we have Massey. He has been quality in defence this week. He has been a solid player. He has been a solid player for Wolfsburg with 67 interceptions in only 20 appearances. He has been superb. Fuck it, I can't even speak.
Superb.
Right back. Another player making a start in 11 is Luke Campin, 12. The right back has been quality for Leverkusen. Picking up 23 interceptions in 14 games. He is definitely a solid
26.
Defender.
26. You said 23. 26.
Did I say 23?
I think you said 23.
26. Okay, CDM, the first midfielder for the Bundesliga Team of the Week is Jawarski. He has been controlling the play in defensive midfield for his team. He now has 58 tackles in 22 appearances, which is amazing. He has definitely earned his spot in Team of the Week. Over to Yardi.
Okay, moving on to left defensive mid. It's an... left centre mid, sorry. Not left defensive mid, what am I about? Left centre mid. Okay, another midfielder in the lineup, played with a guy myself, is Ashley Clark. So well done there, Clarky. He has been quality this week. He now has 136 passes won in only 17 games, which is unbelievable. Well done, lad. Okay, right centre mid this week, we have Smithy7, racking up 13 assists. He has proven to be great.
Utility player,
thanks Dan, for his squad. Keep up the good work for next season. Okay, now moving over to the CAM. First in the attacking players, we have Daniel M, 1993, the Wolfsburg manager himself. He has been amazing for Wolfsburg this week. He has got himself 17 assists in only 20 games. He has definitely earned his spot in Team of the Week this week. Okay, moving over to Dambo to talk about the strikers.
Right. Okay, and striker this week, Ryan Free has been quality up the front for Mönchengladbach. With only 4 goals in 19 games, his scoring record isn't great. His passing ability and hold-up play, however, grants him his spot for Team of the Week. Finally, we have Stuttgart 86, who has been amazing up front for Hamburg. Not only scoring goals, but making 171 passes in 18 games. He is definitely dangerous on the ball. So good luck next season. Next, the bench. Goalkeeper, Sonny Jones, 8 for Hamburger. Centre-back, Mythic Storms for Wolfsburg. Centre-back, Matthew Waters, 15, 4-0 for Leverkusen. Centre-mid, CFI Robert for Wolfsburg. Centre-mid, I McCormick for VfB Stuttgart. JMS in striker for Wolfsburg. And Zed Wilson for Leverkusen. So, there we go. Now we're going over to the Spanish one. Let me just get the picture up and then Yardi can talk about it. That one. There we go.
Okay, so starting from the back in goalkeeper this week, we have number one Munich fan. He has been outstanding in goal for Osasuna. He has done some amazing saves this week. He has now got 101 saves in only 19 appearances and has definitely earned his spot this week in Team of the Week. Okay, moving on to right back this week, we have ADS Danny. I believe he's a CDM, but could be wrong. He has been amazing this week for Real Madrid. He has been saving his team from losing games and also been making his team win games. He has got 77 interceptions and only 22 appearances, which is unbelievable. He has definitely deserved his spot in Team of the Week this week. Next centre-back we have is Legend Campbell. He has been quality at the back this week. His defensive skills have saved his team from losing games. He has now got 30 clearances in only just 10 games, which is amazing. Okay, moving over to Dambo.
Centre-back this week we have Colin McMeekin. 1994, who has been outstanding in centre-back for Osasuna. He has definitely kept his side from losing games. He now has 28 interceptions in only 9 appearances, which is fucking good. He has definitely earned his spot. Okay, Bullard X is in left back, and he's been really good for us, for Real Madrid this week.
Oh, shit.
He has definitely kept his side from losing games. He now has got 32 interceptions in just 19 appearances. CDM for McCowan.
Oh my days.
He has been amazing for Real Madrid this week. Fucking all Real Madrid players. He has definitely been a solid player for Real Madrid in CDM. He now has 29 tackles in only 14 appearances, which is amazing. He definitely deserves to be in Team of the Week, apparently. Okay, over to Yardi.
I've never seen such a corrupt Team of the Week in my life. Okay, next CDM this week is ImJigsawX. He has been outstanding for Real Overdale, that's it, this week. He has been saving his team from losing games, which is amazing. He has now got 31 interceptions in only just 8 games and definitely deserved his spot, mate. Well done there. 31 interceptions, 8 games, very impressive. Okay, moving over to Cam this week, we have Pro Aspect Said. He's been amazing for Real Vallecano this week. He has been making his team win games, which is outstanding. He has now got 13 assists in only 18 appearances and definitely deserves to be in Team of the Week. Well done there, lad. Next Cam this week. Oh, my God. I don't know what to say. Well, let's keep it clean. This week, we have CFI Potted Pete again. He has been outstanding for Real Madrid. I swear, I don't know what he's doing in there, boys and girls. He has definitely been making his team win games. He has now got 16 assists in 10 goals in just only 22 appearances. So, well done there, Pete. Moving over next is to Dambo.
Okay, this week, the unthinkable has been unbelievable for Osasuna. He has been banging loads of goals in. He now has 19 goals in 19 appearances, which is amazing. And that is why he's bagged himself a striker position in the Team of the Week this week. This week, Barsman has been outstanding for Barcelona. He has been banging in goals, making Barca win games. He now has 24 goals in 18 appearances, which is unbelievable. He deserves his spot as striker in Team of the Week this week. Over to the bench, we've got goalkeeper Moody, who plays for Valencia. In defence, we have Tussle Gull, 18-2-10 for Barcelona. And we also got Clem, 1-2-3-4-5 for Barcelona. In midfield, we got King Kendo for Osasuna. Warren, 93 for Osasuna. And in striker, we got Iluki, who plays for Levante. And Spazzy Panda, 98 for Atletico Madrid. And we have the English Team of the Week coming up now, and let me get the picture. Somebody apologises for the picture because the black bart's on the thing, but
we've done our best.
They must have just saved them wrong, but that's all right. It don't matter. You can't fucking read it anyway.
Okay, and last but not least this week, we have the English Team of the Week. Starting in goalkeeper, we have COVID Boss 69. Okay, keeper for Ipswich, making 45 saves and keeping 4 clean sheets. So well done there, lad. Definitely deserves to be in Team of the Week. Centre back, we have A3 Chris. What a rock for Derby. He's managed to bag himself 20 tackles and also getting himself 43 clearances. Definitely proving to be a good centre back there for Derby. Keep it up there, lad. Well done. Moving over next, we have Bradley MC. He's been a war for Newcastle this week. He's managed to bag himself 3 clean sheets in 4 games and also managed to get 15 interceptions and 16 clearances. So well done there, lad. Moving over to Dambo.
This week, TSM Wright, who was a centre-back for Derby, was or is, probably still is. He's got himself 29 interceptions and 25 clearances. I'm not sure how many games he's played, but he definitely deserves his position in centre-back this week. And left-back, it is Lazy Chaos, who has been amazing for Manchester United. And the full-back position, getting 26 tackles and 46 interceptions, so he definitely deserves his spot. Right mid, Kyle Fisher. He's a winger who has been making plenty of passes, 120 to be precise, and getting 17 key passes. So fair play to you, mate. And over to Yardi, who's going to talk about some more people.
Okay, in centre mid this week, we have Shiki. Nonetheless, Shiki, 187, big up to yourself there, bud. Been key in Man City's midfield there, getting 30 key passes and 8 assists. So, well done there, Sheik. Congratulations, mate. Get yourself in Team of the Week. Next centre mid is Ouchie. He's been amazing in defence, defensive midfield player. Sorry. Managed to get himself 53 tackles and 67 interceptions. So, great amount of tackles and interceptions there, lad. Definitely deserve your spot in Team of the Week. Next, we have Minigunner98. He has been a playmaker for Sheffield Wednesday, making 230 passes and also getting himself 28 key passes. So, keep spamming A there, lad, and you'll get yourself in Team of the Week every week. Congratulations. Moving over next to Dumbo.
Right, strikers then. Whoa, a Muddy Helmet. He's done everything as a striker. He's getting 8 goals and 17 assists and also has managed to bag himself 171 passes. So fair play to you, mate, and you're the striker in this week's Team of the Week. We've also got Captain Potato Farmer, who has been the passing striker this week, making 123 passes and 7 assists for his team. So congratulations to you, mate. And for the final time, the bench is Master Daily 12, who's in goal for Birmingham.
Birmingham.
Okay.
Birmingham.
Why is this? What the fuck? Centre-back, Jamie Wrigley, 101 for top-class team Man United. Centre-back, Ace Sparks, who plays for Sheffield Wednesday. Left-back.
Still unbeaten.
Who? Where's Sheffield?
Sheffield Wednesday, yes.
Fucking hell.
We'll talk about that in a minute. Carry on.
Yeah, there's an award in there going. Left-back Byron for Brighton. CDM Zed killed there. That's a name I've been seeing quite a bit. For Sheffield Wednesday.
Shocking player.
Cam Powell, 92 for Brighton. And striker Lenny, 85 for Everton. Right. Let's get that off. Let's get back to this. And we've now got to mention...
Okay. Should I mention anything?
Yeah, you carry on. I don't know anything about it.
No, I didn't think you would. Okay, boys and girls, there's been lots of questions about are we going to do the Champions of Championships, obviously, at the end of the season. Yes, we are, is a question to that. I think what it's going to be is 16 teams, I believe. So it'd be the top three teams for each league and then the best fourth runner-up for over the five leagues. I'm hoping I can try to get this sorted for Thursday night, lads. Let me know, obviously, your availability if you can't make it. I know some leagues it's pretty sort of like known who the top three teams are likely to be. Obviously, like I said, we'll get a thread out and we'll talk more about that, obviously, in due course. Also, oh yes, just to mention before the boys start piping up. Sheffield Wednesday. What do I say about Sheffield Wednesday? Sheffield Wednesday, unbeaten. Giving it the big un. All right.
There's an award in there.
Sheffield Wednesday, there's an award.
For anybody who gets...
There's an award for this, right? So, I just happened to glimpse a glimmer of this whilst it was going on in the shout box about we're unbeaten. So, I have challenged Sheffield Wednesday to a game. Barcelona, Sheffield Wednesday, tomorrow night, 7:30. It's going down, boys, yeah? I bet them that Barcelona will smash them out of the ballpark. And if we don't, I will give their whole team a free 1 month membership. So, Sheffield Wednesday just obviously wanted, you know, give it the big end and give it the hype. So, hopefully now, you know, Barca can go and show them the real way of playing football. Do you know what I mean? Go back to the stream, Dan, and see what people are talking about right now.
Hang on.
Because I can't see shit.
I'm trying to upload these clips.
Right, hang on, Dan's uploading shit. So, give us a second.
Go for it.
Right, okay. What time's that yard? We'll probably do it at the same time, I'm thinking. If we do a straight, obviously, Champions of Championship tournament and we can do it for Thursday, then I think we should start either half 7, 8 o'clock, straight through knockout tournament. I mean, obviously, if we want to do a friendly tournament as well, we can do to run alongside it. But obviously, the top 16 teams on the website will be batting it out, straight knockout, no bullshit. You know what I mean? Straight through tournament, one night done, and obviously, you get yourself an award and all the rest of it, obviously, on your profile. So hopefully that sounds all good. I'm hoping, as Wadda's listening, Wadda, you can bash a thread up on that, mate, yeah? And obviously make sure that all the teams can participate and they all know what's going on. So, boys, I'm guessing you like my Goal of the Week commentary then, yeah? I mean, I just done it for the bants and the giggles, like, do you know what I mean? It was like a little first-time thing. I just thought I'd free-roll in, see what happened, like. Do you know what I mean? Try to make it a little bit different for you. So... I mean, obviously, it's available on YouTube if you want to go and view it again, or you know, tell your mates about it or whatever. You uploading it separately, Dan, as just the Goal of the Week.
Yeah.
So it'd be uploaded to YouTube just as Goal of the Week. So they won't have to watch the whole match of the day if they don't want to. They will just be able to obviously go and watch the Goal of the Week. I think it was the BBVA one. I think it was the one I done the commentary over. What's people saying then? I can't see what people are saying. I just want to beat Barca. Oh, Joe. Have you heard about the Barca striker Barza? Barzy, B man, Barzy. Who's been banging goals in for fun, mate? Okay. Say no more. It'd be an interesting game, I should think. Maybe. Okay. So anything else we want to talk about, boys, before we hit off for the evening? I'll have a look in a minute when Dan quickly clicks on it. But I think we're pretty much concluded the end of the show, boys and girls. So it's just whether you want to mention anything or talk about anything quickly before we go offline. Who's head of GFX? Who's head of GFX is obviously Spank. I forgot that Spank was given obviously head of GFX. Hence the reason, Shibubu, obviously, why you're now part of the BBVA. Yeah, so that was my bad. I forgot all about it. Spank. 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 Spanky, 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 Shibubu. Spank stood down. When did Spank step down? Well, if Spank stepped down, then Shibubu, you are head of admin. I knew that. That's why I give it you in the first place, bruv. All these people just chat pure woof in my ears, you know. Listen. You fucking shit ass admins. Yeah, get your fucking facts right before you start piping up, yeah? Cunts. Oh shit, I swore. Oh bollocks, don't matter. Does it?
Now, yeah?
Yeah, anyway, peace boys and girls. I think we're done, so I'm gone anyway. Nice.